to carry big shipments of ladybugs out to Marston, where the farmers would turn them loose in the lettuce fields to beat up on the aphids. They made sort of a strange cargo that was very bulky but not very heavy. A couple of pounds of ladybugs were packed in a reinforced cardboard box about 1 foot by 1 foot and 6 inches deep. One side of the box was made of screen so the little critters could breathe. The fellows would stuff as many of these boxes as they could fit into the cargo pit. On one depressing gray day, we had 12 passengers, a load of ladybugs, and 2 nice large dogs in kennels. When we got off the ground, the dogs were unhappy, and they began to express their feelings.
What's that terrible noise?
Well, we're carrying a couple of dogs that don't seem to like flying.
Well, I don't like flying either. Can you keep them quiet?
I'll try.
What happens if an engine stops?
Well, nothing much would happen. This plane can easily fly to 12,000 feet with a full load and one engine. I've never seen an engine quit.
But what would happen if they both quit?
Well, look at that great big wing out there. It's very large for the size of the plane. We can glide a long way on these wings even without power. I fly on these planes every day and I really don't worry about it.
That howling sounds like death coming.
I'll do what I can.
Waiter, waiter! That noise is scaring my little girl. Make it stop.
I'll talk to the dogs. I got back there and opened the cargo pit door. The kennels were right there facing into the cabin under a huge pile of ladybug boxes. The dogs were delighted to get some attention and calm down as their ears were scratched. They got nervous again if I moved away from them to do other chores, but as long as they could see me, they howled only occasionally. I sat in the last passenger seat in their sight to do my paperwork. As we churned along, the co-pilot came strolling back from the cockpit, nodding pleasantly to the uneasy passengers. He had an odd expression on his face as he reached me. He leaned over and whispered, "Do you smell smoke?" The nearest passenger was 4 rows away, and normally we had to bellow to be heard over the roar of the mighty engines, but his whisper was heard at the far end of the cabin.
"Smoke! Smoke! Are we on fire? Do you smell anything? Keep the dog quiet! Roar!"
The co-pilot and I quieted the passengers, working our way forward. I had not smelled smoke, and neither had any passenger, but as we got into the companionway behind the cockpit, we could smell hot Bakelite. He opened a hatch and got a stronger whiff of it. He felt around and found a hot spot in one of the radio modules. He unplugged it, pulled it out. Sure enough, a hot resistor was making a little smoke and stink. The thing cooled right away and there was no other problem. It didn't affect our flight. He showed the module to passengers to reassure them, but he didn't show it to the dogs, who kept on howling. As I crouched to pet them, I noticed a couple of ladybugs on my sleeve. I flicked them off, then found some more. My eye was caught by a strange movement in the cargo pit, and I realized that everything was covered with cute little crawling and fluttering ladybugs looking for aphids to eat. The place was alive with them. I quickly closed the door.
"Waiter, waiter, stop that infernal racket. We're all very much upset."
I opened the door and the howling stopped, but a wave of ladybugs advanced into the cabin. The cargo handlers had shoved the bug boxes in so vigorously that they'd stripped away a lot of the tape that was sealing the screens, and the enterprising critters were out in the town. Many flew forward in the cabin.
"Get off me!"
"Just brush those away, dear!"
"Eek!
Shut that door, you fool! Stop those banshees!"
I left the door open to cheer up the dogs and the bugs. The bugs were out anyway. The passengers got used to them and spent the rest of the flight morosely brushing clumps of ladybugs from one another. No big deal, really. Nobody hurt, and we were all certainly aphid-free by the time the passengers straggled off the plane into the arms of their loved ones. As the captain came down the aisle, he asked what all the racket had been about. I told him. "What?" he said. "Again?"